Welcome back. Today I want to talk about how to work biceps. I'm going to show you a couple different exercises that I would recommend, why I recommend them, and how you can progress your bicep growth or the way you want to tone up your biceps and do them properly. Okay? So let's get started. We're going to set up the camera and I'll show you a few different exercises. Okay, gang. The body part that we are doing today is the bicep, so we're going to go ahead and talk about it real briefly. The bicep has different parts to it, and you want to be able to get the most out of your exercises that you perform with those muscles. Now, you have what's called the long head of the bicep and the short head of the bicep. Now, you also have a brachioradialis, which runs across your elbow. Now, the exercise that I'm going to teach is your basic barbell curl, and how to grab it and how to get the most out of it and why. We're also going to be doing some cable curls, some twisting dumbbell curls, and even some incline bench curls. Now, the first one we're going to do is going to be the straight bar barbell curl. And the way we're going to do that is I'm going to go ahead and get behind the bar, and I'm going to explain it from there. Okay, now that I'm positioned behind the bar where I want to be, I'm going to show you how to properly put your hand to the bar and do the proper curl. All right, what you want to do is you want to stand center to the bar, make sure you're perfectly even. Your feet are going to be about shoulder width apart. You're going to have a good stance, okay? You're then going to take your hands, relaxed as they are, and just turn them forward, just like this. You're going to relax, you're going to turn them forward. Now, once you're turning them forward, you're going to bend down and just grab the bar. Now, I'm going to take a look, and I'm going to adjust my grip just a little bit so that I know that it's perfectly even on the bar according to the markings that are on your most of your Olympic bars. So I know where my grip is. It's right about here. And now I'm going to stand up. And you get prepared. And you don't just start trying to curl right away, because you want to prepare for how your muscle is going to feel during that exercise. You don't want to just rush into something and then hurt something. Okay, so I'm going to take this and I'm going to use a very controlled motion, and it's going to go like this. I'm going to curl up to this point here, squeezing the bicep at the same time. Come down, come back up, squeeze, come down, come back up, squeeze. Nice and controlled. Now, the benefit of doing this is that I'm working both the long head and the short head at the same time because of my natural grip. I'm not having to turn my wrists in. I'm not having to kink anything up like you would have to do with a cambered bar. A lot of people think that this is actually the best bar to do curls on. I find that it's not, because the cambered bar, nicknamed the easy curl bar, actually isolates the short head of your bicep, and it reduces your production by 13%. So if your goal is to get the most out of your exercise, then go with the straight bar. And you can really go heavy with it, and you want to put it as your first exercise for that muscle, because you always want to utilize the heaviest and the hardest exercise in the beginning when your muscles are the freshest. Okay? So you're gonna continue to do those for about 4 to 8 reps if you're looking for size. You probably want to go about 8 to 12 if you want to just tone up what you have. So make sure that the weight that you're doing will allow you, if you're building, to get to 4, but not to 8. That's where you have to find the magic number. And every day that's going to be different. Now, you can keep track of it in your logbook, which I always recommend, but some days you're just not going to feel it, and some days you're going to feel it even more. So you're going to start out with that first set. You're going to get to that 4, and you're going to see, can I get to 6? Can I get to 7? If I can't get to 8, perfect weight, right there. That's the one you want to get to. Now, you also want to control the weight as it's going down, because you're also going to get a lot of benefit out of that. So you want to get the benefit out of both the positive and the negative exercise. Okay, the positive and the negative. So, that is the barbell curl, and let's go move on to the next one. Okay, the next exercise we moved on to is going to be the incline dumbbell curl. And the reason we do that in an incline is because when the muscle has all the proper tension in the back, it's going to be able to work all the way up. Now, if I was just standing and I was doing a barbell curl or doing dumbbell curls, the first third of that motion is actually the most beneficial that you're going to get in that curl. So as I'm doing that third, the next two thirds of that part of the motion is less effective on my bicep. So again, I want to get the most out of every motion and every movement and exercise that I have. Okay, because now, so when I go ahead and get on the bench and I decline and I pull my shoulder back to a point where now the tension is going to be all the way back on the bicep, and as I curl with that dumbbell, it's going to have more pulling it up, more than just that one third. It's going to get past the two third point, and it's going to benefit me even more from there. Okay, so what I'm going to go ahead and do is get positioned, grab the dumbbell, and I'm going to let it hang straight back. Notice that my shoulder is pulled back. My arm is relatively straight to the floor. I could then grab a bench or just position my feet. For me, I pretty much prefer a bench. And I'm going to control this motion, and I'm going to pull it all the way up, and I can feel it right to about there. And then I have to squeeze the bicep. It's a contraction. You want to contract the bicep to a point, to a real, real strong point. And then bring it back down, go back to the straight, and come right back up and curl. Come all the way back and curl. And you want to avoid swinging, so I'm not doing all this quick motion just to get it done. I want to get to a point where that muscle fails when I'm trying to curl that up, and I'm trying to get all the way down slowly and curl it all the way up. And I want to take about 3 seconds to go up. One, two, three, down, two, three. Okay? One, two, three, down, two, three. That's my motion, that's my count, because I want to get the full contraction and the full benefit of the exercise. So I want to keep that bicep more, get more tension on it. I want to get more strength out of it. I want to get more exercise. So that's why I lean it back. And I go through that proper motion. From there, we would do the same thing with the cable exercise. We would stand at a cable, we would reach back with that cable, and we would curl that cable forward, okay? We would curl that cable forward, and we would work that exercise, okay? You could do both with the cable and the dumbbell. You can do them both in the same day, but when you get to failure on those, you know that your failure is based on your you've done everything proper and you've pushed that bicep to its end. All right, gang, this is what we're gonna do for our third exercise. It's called the standing alternating dumbbell twist. And the reason why we do a twist is because we already know that the bicep works in a manner where we curl things up towards our shoulder, like so. This is the exercise that we do, this is the action that it does. Okay, we know that contracts the bicep and it works it properly. Now, what we also know is that the bicep works as we twist our wrist, okay? That's also done by the bicep, okay? So what we're gonna do is we're gonna combine these two motions into one exercise and try to get the full benefit out of that motion, all right? We're gonna take the dumbbell, it's gonna face forward like so, okay? And we're going to bring it up slowly and bring it down and twist. Bring it up and bring it down. Bring it up, bring it down. Bring it up and bring it down. Bring it up and bring it down. And bring it up and bring it down, okay? Now, we're doing a combination of a couple different things there. We're working the brachioradialis, which is the muscle that cuts across the elbow, which actually helps push the bicep up and makes it appear larger than what it is. It also make your grip and your curls much, much more productive. The twisting is contracting more of the short head of the bicep. The curling is actually working both the long head and the short head of the bicep. So we're really working a combination of those, the bicep muscle in these exercises. So if I was working with two, a lot of times I like to do them both at the same time. I bring them up, I turn, I bring them down. I bring them, curl them up, I bring them a turn, I bring them down. Bring them up, and I turn. Now, you can do alternating dumbbell where you would bring it up and down and like this. Just like that. And it would just bring them up and bringing them down. Okay? Now, that's the alternating one. I like to do them both at the same time so that I have full control and I'm not getting all confused and I'm making sure I'm concentrating on that contraction of the muscle, and it's just easier for me to do them both at the same time. I can squeeze, I can get that contraction at the top, I can feel that exercise going slowly down, and I can feel it go, and the exercise strengthening as I go back up. So as I have said over and over again, I want to get the most out of every exercise, out of every motion and that I do for the bicep. So that's my third exercise. Now let's go ahead and move on to the last one. And this one is more of a, we're gonna burn it out, we're gonna waste the muscle, we're gonna get the most blood to it as we can, so that when our protein is in our blood system, that it's already gone to repair these muscles and fix them and give our body the nutrients and stuff that we need. All right, let's move on to the next exercise, and it's our last exercise. All right, gang, the last exercise that we're gonna do for the bicep is known as the preacher curl. And the preacher curl is done with this attachment, which is known as the preacher attachment. And it's just a slanted mat here like this that you would rest the entire arm on. You're gonna put the armpit over that cushion. You're gonna place the arm flat up against that pad, and you're gonna try to keep it there. What I do is I block myself here, and I put my hand on the bicep to keep it down, because I don't wanna lift it up. I don't wanna do all this extra motion, because that's involving the deltoid. And what I wanna do is I wanna really focus on doing as many reps as I can and squeezing as hard as I can. Now, I'm not doing that 3 second up, 3 second down, because my goal is to burn this out, okay? So let me just grab the dumbbell, and all I'm gonna do is I'm gonna hold that muscle in the proper form, that's straight as best I can, not angled in like this right now, because my goal is to hit both heads of my bicep at the same time. I wanna hit that long head, that outer muscle, that outer half of the bicep, as much as I wanna hit that inner half of the bicep. So I'm gonna turn that out just a little bit, okay? And I'm gonna put my hand here, and I'm just gonna bring it all the way down to that part where it's the most tension, and it's all the way, my arm's almost straight out. Not always straight, but 99%. And I'm gonna bring that right up, and I'm gonna squeeze, and I'm gonna bring it down, and I'm gonna squeeze, and I'm gonna bring it down, I'm gonna squeeze, and I'm just gonna try to burn this out, okay? I'm just gonna keep going until I can't do any more of these curls, okay? Now, that exercise right there is gonna feel, you're gonna get such a pump out of it that it'll probably be one of your favorite exercises to finish with. Now, one bonus exercise that I would do on top of that is to hit the brachioradialis, which is that muscle again that goes across your elbow here, across the front of your elbow. And then I'm gonna turn this weight so that it's a 90 degrees from what I was just having it. And I'm gonna hold my arm down again, just like I did before, and I'm gonna bring it down to that almost straight and bring it back up. And you're gonna feel that in the upper part of your forearm, in the inner elbow, and then hopefully you feel it within the bicep itself as well. So I'm gonna do these, and they're known as what's called hammer preacher curls, okay? And this is just a bonus one. I'm just gonna try to burn out this, doing this exercise here, and the preacher curl, and then I would switch it to the other arm. Now, this machine here happens to come with an attachment that is already like this. Now, this exercise, this bar is set up straight so that I can actually go ahead and lock my elbows into that, onto those pads, and then I would just curl it up, and I could just burn this out at the same time. And that's my goal, is to get that perfectly curled exercise right here. Now, with this bar, even though it's not meant to be used in such a manner, I'll grab the inside grips here like this, okay? And I'll try and burn out that brachioradialis, okay? That smaller muscle. And I'm gonna do that, and it's like almost like a hammer curl. And I'm gonna burn these out, and I'm just gonna keep working. Now, the pads keep me honest. The pads keep me from cheating because this particular preacher bench has these side panels. Not all of them have that, but so you have to mentally focus and really stay in a controlled manner, okay? And the key to all this is to get the blood flow going to that muscle, to break down the muscle in a proper manner, to listen to your muscles, to not put yourself in pain. The old adage where there's no pain, no gain, there was, to a point, that was true. But in reality, when there's pain, that's the body telling you there's something wrong. So you want to make sure that the pain that you're feeling is not bad pain, because that's when you want to stop. That's when you want to listen to your body. That's when you want to make sure that you're doing the form properly. And that's what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to get you to do the proper form, get you the most out of your exercise, and to get the benefits from what you want to get from these exercises. Now that's the bicep. We're going to do other body parts. I hope this is helpful. I hope you can get some information out of this. If you have any other questions, please leave comments, leave questions down below. This is a weight loss vlog, I guess we can call it. And I am losing the weight. I'm going to release tomorrow my results for the first month, okay? And that will be tomorrow, along with the measurements that I'm going to do compared to the measurements that I did 30 days ago. All right? So I hope all my subscribers are continuing to watch and benefiting from some of these videos. I hope you're passing on to people you know. If you do want to see more, please subscribe. Please like my videos. And if you fail to plan to fail. Okay, guys? We'll see you next time. Thanks.